Hello everybody, this is Michael. In this video, we will talk about the FPGA driver SPI TFT LCD02 system analysis. Okay, so let's take a look what's the system structure, what's the system module for this project. So first things, we will have the FPGA module. Of course, we use FPGA to control LCD. We need one FPGA module. Next, we need the LCD. So the first signal will be the LCD reset signal. The FPGA use this signal to reset the LCD. The next signal will be the CS signal. It's a select signal. So will enable the LCD. Okay, so next signal is the data and the command signal. So FPGA use this signal to tell the LCD, I send you date or command. Okay, so next signal will be the clock signal. We use the SPI protocol, so we need one clock signal. And the next signal will be the data signal. So FPGA send data command through this signal to the LCD. Okay, of course, so we'll have the clock signal from the crystal on the ball. And we will also have the reset signal, the system reset signal, okay? And then let's take a look at the inside FPGA. So first module, we will have the LCD reset module. Next module, we will have the SPI driver module. And the last module will be LCD driver module. We use this module to control the LCD reset module and the SPI driver module. So for the LCD reset module, we have one LCD reset output signal to connect this signal. For the LCD reset module, we also have the clock, the system clock input signal. And we also have the system reset signal. And also we have the enable input signal. It from the LCD driver module. The LCD driver module use this signal to enable the LCD reset module. After the LCD reset module finish its work, and then we use the done output signal to tell the LCD driver module this part already done. Okay. Next, we will use SPI driver module to generate the CS signal, to generate the select signal to tell the LCD to choose the LCD. And next, we will generate the data and command signal from the SPI driver module. Also, we will generate the clock and data for the SPI protocol. Of course, we will have the clock and reset from the system clock and system reset. So next, the LCD driver will use the enable signal to control the SPI driver module. The LCD driver will use the data signal, send the data. The LCD driver will send the data through the data signal to the SPI driver. When the SPI driver finishes his job and then use the done output signal to tell the LCD driver module, the SPI driver module's work is done. Okay, so of course, for the LCD driver, we will have the clock input and the reset input signal. So this is the whole system module. This is the whole system block for the FPGA driver, SPI, TFT's LCD system. Okay, so next time, we will start from the LCD reset module. Let's take a look how we coding it, how we analyze it, code it, and simulate it. Okay, so that's it. This is the FPGA driver, SPI, TFT, LCD, 02 system analysis. This is Michael. Thank you for your watching. See you next time.